Letang. I'm going to tell you exactly where this is going to go. Couldn't have drawn it up any better. The fake shot, the kick out, and a shot through a screen through the legs of Braun to end this game for the Pittsburgh Penguins.
He took Letang and he switched sides. He moved Dumoulin to his one-timer side. So everybody in the building thinks it's going to go to Letang, then over to Dumoulin for a one-timer, and Sheary escapes coverage. Switched by the D, they're both on their one-timer, and he wins it clean. And what a shot.
Do this, but when once the puck is actually on the ice, it's Crosby's, the meat of his blade, that gets to cusp the puck more, and then you usually see a San Jose Shark on the outside looking in, much like the barrel of a bat when you hit a baseball. Crosby's able to get the good portion of the blade on the puck, and we've got a couple examples of this here, and this is Spalling here. Look at Spalling's stick on the outside. It's Crosby that gets the big portion of his blade back. This is as clean, folks, as you'll ever see on a face-off, and I don't know why, Kelly, they continue to try to win draws.
Yeah.
I mean,
I don't get it, Nick. Why wouldn't they just get ready as though we're having a face-off?
Yeah.
Why wouldn't the Shark player just sort of either come on this side or take away his backhand?
You know
what? Tie him up.
Every time I've seen a face-off guy on our team struggle, the whole idea was, listen, don't try to beat him.
Yeah.
Just tie him up and let us come in and try to help you. Create 50-50 pucks. Much better opportunity to win a puck battle than what we've seen so far against Crosby, George.
All right, thank you very much, Nick. 8 and